just leaving the Chivers Triangle at Burnley. South of England's bathed in sunshine, Burnley's bathed in cloud cover. But it's not cold, it's pleasantly warm. Amazing how those trees literally grow out of the wall. Of course it undermines the structure of the wall. A bit late now though, they've got to be really big things. So this is a long straight aqueduct we're on. The canal is way above the surrounding countryside. Burnley Football Club over on the left hand side there. Engineering that went into building this sheer hard graft with pick and shovel, and we're above the rooftops. Amazing. And that looks like serious rain too. Come on. There's the bus station. seem to be a lot of herons around this area. And they're tame, really. They're just not interested at all in us going by. Live in these houses along this stretch of the canal, chuck all their rubbish down the bottom of the garden, all on the canal banks. Beautiful old stonework on that building. This old Hall Mill. Offices now. Beautiful stonework though. Lovely old wharf buildings that are now residential. Still got the mooring rings into the stonework there. an old town gas holder. Used to see him all the time once upon a time. Of course, town gas was manufactured from coal. All since long gone, since North Sea oil. Again, all the mooring rings are still in the stonework. Back to the day when they used to moor up there and unload. It's parking now for the residential part of the old mill. Doesn't actually look like it's lived in, really. That's it, school holidays are over. There's another wharf where they had a canopy over to protect them from the elements. Big crane and hoist left there. Well, that pontoon's for the geese, not the boats. Well, there's yet more weed hatch. Excitement this time. It's a very heavy duty black refuse sack. The Liverpool and Leeds Canal, once you've gone past the Wigan flight, is a nightmare. I'll persevere, but I'll never come this way again. And there we are. So, as you saw, I had a massive weight, heavy duty black refuse bag. It was wrapped right around the propeller and it made the transmission sound so noisy I thought perhaps there was something wrong with the gearbox, both forwards and reverse. And it was right in the middle of a wider part of the canal and I had absolutely no power at all. Fortunately, there was an overhanging branch that I could just reach with the boat hook, and I managed to pull the boat in close enough to the bank to jump off and sort it out. But it has been an experience, this canal. It probably explains why there's hardly any boat movement at all on it. You hardly see a single thing moving. Well, I moan about people coming mooring near me, but I'm going to do it. No, tomorrow. Well, it's another beautiful morning, September the 8th, I believe, today. So, a week into September now, and it's nice and warm. Hiya! And we're at Barrowford Bottom Lock on our way up towards Skipton. The canal now, the duckweed has disappeared, which is a blessing, and hopefully we'll have a weed hatch free day. Anyway, let's see what the day brings. Every night I've been deciding what is really for the best. Every night I'm hearing voices telling me motorways now over where once would have been just canal. Really, really interesting. Every night I've been deciding actually a great view from the top of the lock. And over there in the distance, they're lowering the reservoir, making it deeper, I guess. Tonight, you know I'm gonna let you down.
Up the pieces I can't find tonight.